invite Eliana for the second reading.
A reading from the second letter of Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, knowing that the one who raised the Lord Jesus will raise us also with Jesus and place us with you in his presence. Everything indeed is for you, so that the grace bestowed in abundance on more and more people may cause the thanksgiving to overflow for the glory of God. Therefore, we are not discouraged. Rather, although our outer self is wasting away, our inner self is being renewed day by day. For this momentary light affliction is producing for us an eternal weight of glory beyond all comparison, as we look not to what is seen, but to what is unseen. For what is seen is transitory, but what is unseen is eternal. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "When the Son of Man comes in his glory, and all the angels with him, he will sit upon his glorious throne, and all the nations will be assembled before him, and he will separate them one from another. As a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats, he will place the sheep on his right and the goats on his left. Then the king will say to those on his right, 'Come, you who are blessed by my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. For I was hungry, and you gave me food. I was thirsty, and you gave me drink. A stranger, and you welcomed me, naked, and you clothed me, ill, and you cared for me, in prison, and you visited me.' Then the righteous will answer him and say, 'Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you drink? When did we see you a stranger and welcome you, or naked and clothe you? When did we see you ill or in prison and visit you?' The king will say to them in reply, 'Amen, I say to you, whatever you did for one of these least brothers of mine, you did for me.' Then he will say to those on his left, 'Depart from me, you accursed, into the eternal fire prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was hungry, and you gave me no food. I was thirsty, and you gave me no drink. A stranger, and you gave me no welcome. Naked, and you gave me no clothing. Ill, and in prison, and you did not care for me.' Then they will answer and say, 'Lord, when did we see you hungry or thirsty, or a stranger, or naked, or ill, or in prison, and not minister to your needs?' He will answer them, 'Amen, I say to you, what you did not do for one of these least ones, you did not do for me.' And these will go off to eternal punishment, but the righteous to eternal life. The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated for just a few moments. Dear Maria Margarita, Teresita, Carmen, Monica, Patricia, Cecilia, Emily, Lily, Suzanne, Jaime, and Roberto, and Marta, Calixto's sister, and Fausto, if he is here, 27 grandchildren and 5 great-grandchildren, if they are here present or following us through internet and video. As we have just heard in the Book of Lamentations, in the first reading, my soul is downcast within me, and my soul is deprived of peace. We miss Calixto, but also, as we have just heard, the Lord is good to those who wait for him and to the soul that seeks him. I think these words summarize Calixto's life. He sought him, he sought our Lord every single day. Calixto waited for our Lord and sought him, even though, as we read in the second reading, his outer self was wasting away, but his inner self, his inner person, progressed all the more. We know this even to the last day of his life, as his caregiver Christina has revealed to us. He was obedient to death, to his spiritual plan of life. And she witnessed this herself, because Calixto followed a regular routine. As she described it, he would wake up every day, pray the rosary, drink a cup of coffee, and smoke a cigar. I think in the Gospel of today's Mass, as we have heard the corporal works of mercy, I was thirsty and you gave me to drink, I was hungry and you gave me food, I was naked and you clothed me, we have to add one more. I needed a Cuban cigar and you gave it to me. That was Calixto. And I would say that that was a spiritual work, because he conversed with you. He was always open to talk. As a good Cuban, he had the gift of the word, the gift of tongues, we could say. He had a great ear to listen, a great sense of humor, and also an uncommon common sense. He was very down to earth. Even in his last day, when he told his caregiver, he had a malaise, and his caregiver was cleaning him up, he told her, "Today, don't you know today is the day I die?" And he said, "But don't worry, don't cry. Death is natural." What a great sense of humor, especially coming from a pathologist. He was, he knew a lot about death as a doctor, as a pathologist. And more than natural, I think for him, death was also supernatural. If we were to ask him now, "Can you tell us about death?" he would not tell us all, he could tell us all the scientific reasons why a person dies, but right now I think he would describe it as an encounter with our Lord, meeting Mary, must be an amazing thing, to whom he had a lot of devotion, especially to Our Lady of La Caridad del Cobre, the Cuban apparition, to those people who were astray in the ocean, and she appeared to them. Calixto was born in Cuba, and as many Cubans in the 1960s, early 1960s, he came to Florida. He immigrated to Florida, fleeing from the communist regime that had taken over the island. And he settled in Chicago and worked at the Cook County Hospital at first to redo his residency, and then for many years thereafter at St. Joseph's Hospital here right by the lake. And I remember visiting him there probably 2 years ago when he had congestive heart failure, and they had a spectacular room overlooking the lake, and I said, Calixto, they treat you really well here. I says, they better. I've been working here for 50 years or so, and I know everybody, and everybody, I said, well, that's good. And he said, the only bad thing about this hospital is I can't smoke. I said, okay, don't worry about it. We'll come out of that in a second. But the most important thing he did is he loves his wife, Gisela, who preceded him in death in this life a few years ago, but with whom he engendered 12 children. And I believe they're all here present. 12 children that were the love of his life with her. So it was our Lord, our Lady, his wife, and his children, and his friends. He was a man of friendship. He knew many people and was always willing to dialogue with them. And these were the three things that really mattered to him: faith, family, friendship. And his heightened sense of humor and his heightened common sense led him to evangelize. Julio, his son-in-law, was telling me yesterday that one of the first things he did when, I suppose when Patricia and he got married, or before, right before, or right after, I don't know, he said, gave him a book on St. John, St. John's Gospel. And he told him, and he wrote in the back, he said, Julio, you need to work on three things. I hope I'm not revealing something very personal. As a son-in-law, you gotta work on three things: divine filiation, obedience, I suppose, to Patricia, and detachment, you know, because marriage is about wealth or poverty or whatever it is, to be detached, you know. And so Calixto cared about the spiritual life of other people, and he talked so naturally to them about God, about Our Lady. He was also, one of his virtues was generosity, magnanimity. He was very, very generous, and he supported many works of apostolate, St. Mary of the Angels being one of them, but another one where he would make a retreat every year, or a conference, a spiritual conference, like Rosaire Conference Center in right north of Miami, or Shelbourne right here in Indiana, or the schools that his children attended, or Midtown Program right next door to us. And one of the things that he did is he donated money to build mosaics, to put mosaics up. He had one of La Virgen de la Caridad in Miami, and he was there for the inauguration of that. He was very proud of that. And also mosaics like the one of Our Lady of Guadalupe at Northridge, or I believe even here, or at Shelbourne, so that people can actually be led to Our Lady, be led to God through beauty. Through beauty. He loved art. He loved his faith, and both combined as well. He met the spirituality of Saint Jose Maria in the 1960s when he came over here through a man by the name of Ramon Casas, who is also Cuban and also a doctor, I believe. And since then, he led a plan of life that Saint Jose Maria led, and a plan of life that allowed him to sanctify his ordinary work as a doctor, seeing Christ behind his patients, behind his colleagues, behind nurses and doctors that he worked with, trying to offer that up and make a sacrifice out of his daily work and his social dealings. Calixto will be greatly missed, but as I have received a letter from the prelate of Opus Dei, whom he met when he was here a few years ago, in 2019, right before the pandemic, he wrote a letter expressing his condolences, and he asked me to extend his condolences and prayers to his family. And he says, I'll read it in Spanish, and I'm sure everyone here understands, at least in the family, except the grandchildren, I've been told, but anyway, that's work in progress. Me acaban de comunicar la noticia del fallecimiento de Calixto, y os pongo estas líneas mientras me uno a vuestros sufragios por su eterno descanso. Me contabais que ha fallecido con gran paz en el hospital. Todo fallecimiento nos apena, pero no podemos estar tristes. Al contrario, demos gracias al Señor por la vida de Calixto y su entrega llena de fruto. Esa alegría que desprendía es fiel reflejo de saberse en las manos de Dios, que como buen padre siempre nos da lo mejor. Vale la pena darnos por completo en servicio a Dios y a los demás. Los ejemplos de tantas personas de casa que gozan ya del cielo nos pueden servir para identificarnos más con Jesús y ser cada vez más felices aquí en la tierra. Calixto se nos ha ido después de una larga vida en la que no han faltado sacrificios y alegrías. Y al final, como resumía San José María, todo alegrías. Transmitida a sus hijos y a los de su centro, Midtown, mi pésame. Rezo por todos ellos a la Santísima Virgen y les pido que me ayuden con su oración por mis intenciones. Nos acercamos a la fiesta del Corpus Christi, que nos invita a contemplar más a Jesucristo en la Eucaristía y considerar de modo más profundo su amor por nosotros. Os envía su más cariñosa bendición y os encomienda vuestro padre Fernando. I will make this available for the family, and you can translate it to your family members. But in essence, he sends his condolences and prayers, and he says very beautifully that even though Calixto has suffered and through his life and also had many joys in his life, right now it's all joy. It's all joy. Well, let us turn to Our Lady of Charity of Cuba and entrust his soul to her. And we can all say a memorare together for the repose of his soul. Remember, O most gracious Virgin Mary, that never was it known that anyone who fled to thy protection, implored thy help, or sought thine intercession was left unaided. Inspired by this confidence, I fly unto thee, O Virgin of Virgins, my Mother. To thee I come, before thee I stand, sinful and sorrowful. O Mother of the Word incarnate, despise not my petitions in our necessities, but deliver us from all dangers, O ever glorious and blessed Virgin. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please stand for the prayer of the faithful, and I invite those relatives of Calixto to please come forward. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father. Here he intercedes for his church, confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus. We join our prayers to his.
Please respond, Lord, hear our prayer. That God, our Lord, enrich our Holy Father, Pope Francis, our Bishop Blaise Cupich, and our prelate, Don Fernando Ocariz, with spiritual gifts, and strengthen all priests and religious so that they preach the word of God in all its fullness. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Opus Dei, that the prelature's faithful, its cooperators, and all who take part in its apostolate may turn all the circumstances and events of their life into occasion of loving and servicing all souls with joy and simplicity, lighting up the pathways of this earth with faith and love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the deceased members of our family with whom our willow is now united to more closely, in thanksgiving for their lives and their witnesses to love, especially for our willow, let us pray to the Lord.
For all who are part of the Maso family, extended family, and friends alike, that they may share abundant blessings in the thanksgiving of our widow's gift of love, support, and example, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That families and all who have lived with autism and other disabilities will find their faith to be a source of strength, community, and hope, let us pray to the Lord.
For migrants, refugees, and all other strangers in our midst, that they may find strength in our concern for justice and feel the warmth of our love, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a deeper vision for our lives and directions, may we hear and embrace God's call to serve each other and generously respond to meeting the needs of the lonely and suffering. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer Jesus Christ and the voices of your people whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
There's sadness ever joy.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Calixto, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, the resurrection of the dead. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim.
Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth, veni sunt geni et terrae gloria. Hosanna in excelsis, benedictus qui venit in nomine Domini. Hosanna in excelsis.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Jose Maria, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Blaise, our Bishop, and Fernando, our prelate, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Calixto, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters, too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes, for seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Pecado del mundo, en piedad de los
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let perpetual light shine upon them, with your saints forever, for you are merciful. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord, and let perpetual shine upon them, with your saints forever, for you are merciful.
Afraid.
would like to invite the family to bring the flowers to Our Lady. I would like to invite Roberto for some words of remembrance for his father on behalf of the family.
Lots of girls, lots of girls. I used to joke with my father, if he had 10 sons, he would have died many years ago. Okay. Did you know that Superman had a sweet tooth and liked to smoke cigars? Y a Superman le gustó los pasteles, los postres y fumar puros, pero en este orden. He was a man of many names. For many of us, it was Papi, for others, Abuelo. For some, Dr. Masso. For some, Calixto, Cal, Kiko, Calypso, if you couldn't pronounce it. Born in 1930, yesterday was his birthday, Camagüey, Cuba. He had a love for knowledge, reading, and science, and quickly chose a doctorate in pathology. He was also rumored to have been a very good swimmer, but if you asked him, he said it was a small island we all had to. So. By the time when he was 28, he married the girl of his dreams. By By 1961, they had two kids, and the third one was on the way. But with so much change in the places where they were, they had to make a choice to leave every possession that they ever had earned behind. And they chose the harder path. They landed after leaving their house, their car, their farm, their bank accounts, everything they ever owned behind. They landed in Cuba with, or excuse me, in Miami with a bag of clothes, two children, and 2 days later, their third child was born. My father would say, he would say many times, they took away everything from me. They could not take, they could not take away my faith. They could not take away my education. He quickly found work from a friend who had lent him a car as well. And he said he got his first check and it was $300. And he said he felt like a millionaire. He immediately took your mother to get a bigger apartment. It wasn't too long after that that he found work at Cook County in Chicago. And before that, started his long career at Columbus Hospital. At that same time, a close friend of his took him to a small Catholic order called Opus Dei, where he was a great fit, sanctifying the daily life, making the daily things you do in your life, your daily activities, making them holy, and that fit well with who he was. Over the next 14 years, he had 9 more children. And we used to joke around, we'd ask, was like, did you ever think about money before having kids? He'd say, no. And we'd say, why? He said, well, we always had money. He always handled things with a lot of grace. There was no problem too big, nothing too great that he couldn't solve with tranquility and grace. And we'd ask him how he did that. And he would say, life, he said this very recently, life is not a rose garden. Life is full of problems. But if you do what you have to do, you can find joy in your problems. Throughout the rest of his life, he would continue his great passions for reading, arguing, his love of family and work, and giving glory to God. I think to describe my father, you could say a lot of things. As a great faith, a devout Catholic, very humble man, a man of action who would rather show you what he believes than tell you about it. But above all, I think what made him so unique individual was he was a man who loved God. So many of us, very few people even go to Mass on a regular basis. Many of us go because out of fear, or go because it's in the rule book. But my father had a true relationship with God and loved God above all things. And that's why I know he's in heaven now, dancing with his wife for the first time in 20 years. Thank you.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body food for the journey, mercifully grant that strengthened by it, our brother Calixto may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Now we will have the final commendation, where we will pray for Calixto's soul and bid him farewell. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Into your hands, Father of Mercies, we commend our brother Calixto, in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you have bestowed upon Calixto in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with the assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our brother forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. In peace, let us take our brother to his place of rest.
Regina, mater misericordiae, vita dulcedo, et spes nostra salve, parte caramus, ex foras filii Eve, parte suspiramus, gerentes et gentes, in aec lacrimarum vale. Ea ergo, advocata nostra, illos tuos misericordes oculos a nos converte. Et Iesu, benedictum fructum ventris tui, nos To shine.